Hello everybody, this is BladeCrossExe.
And Ryoji42.
And welcome to Kingdom Hearts 2.8. And...
oh boy.
The hype train just keeps on chugging.
I can't handle myself right now. I am ecstatic.
It's gonna be a good week, I tell you that right now. We got a convention coming up this weekend, brand new Kingdom Hearts game for us to enjoy, and we got it a day before release because it was released at 9 o'clock. It's currently about 11 where we are right now. We're gonna power through the sucker tonight.
Can we get started?
Yeah, let's
Let's go!
Breath by Sleep. Yeah, let's begin that, yeah.
0.02. It's gotten to the point where every time I see a decimal point, I get excited. People can complain all they want, just give me more.
Wait till 2.9 comes out. Alright, fair warning, just in case this little intro is copyrighted like it was on our Fate Extella video, we may have to cut this out too. But I'm hoping it's not. Wait, does it mean on the Unreal Engine?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, explain what exactly is the Unreal Engine. Is it at all related to...
no idea.
Is it related to Unreal Tournament at all? Or...
I don't know.
Like, that's just... I sound like a total noob for asking that, but that's just... that was always my impression.
I mean, I didn't see a left heart to begin with. Go.
I didn't see left heart either, but I see it barely on the right side.
Alone Z plus Ultra. Let's do this!
Disney Interactive Studios. How long has it been since last game came out? 3-4 years? Since Dream Drop?
It's been a little while.
Yeah. How long has it been since Kingdom Hearts 2 is a better question.
How long will it be till Kingdom Hearts 3 is the big question?
Just another 10 years, you know. Oh, isn't this familiar soon for the Kingdom Hearts universe?
Oh boy. Probably cutting this. But oh boy, I have chills. I cannot handle myself. It's so cute.
There it is. I'm gonna spare you guys.
Who sings this?
It's out of hate, girl.
That hurts.
Okay.
I can go to your text.
We should do that. We should just play the text. I'm getting chills now. Insert Dragon Ball Z joke here.
To be watching it on my TV.
Oh boy.
13 stars and darkness.
Now, I'm gonna be a little bit lost because I still haven't beaten Optimus Mode Breath by Sleep yet, and I haven't played Dream Drop yet, so. I'm probably gonna get some spoilers here. I beat Ventus and Terra's mode, so I got 2 of 13 done.
This is the important one!
I'm stuck in the Levison, okay? I'm playing on Proud Mode. Just finishing up Aqua's tale from where she left off in the World of Darkness, I don't really expect it to be that super long.
Well, however it works, yeah. I will probably play through this about 8 times.
Yeah, because you actually have the PS4.
Alright. I would find a way even if I didn't.
Hacks.
Oh my god.
That is a beautiful tile screen, though. Okay, considering...
it's so pretty.
Okay, considering we get...
welcome back, guys.
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
Proud mode. Proud mode all the way.
It doesn't start with critical?
No.
I guess that's just gonna be a me thing.
Yes. Okay, I take back what I said about this looking like it's gonna be short if we're gonna get a loading screen. Or a load menu.
Okay, so... shortcuts, move cursor, move character, we might just skip through this, but oh well. Block. Confirm. Form situation.
We know how to play Kingdom Hearts. Between us, we played all but like one of the games.
Look. They change stuff up.
They do.
Mechanics are a thing.
Ooh.
He made Graveyard back once again.
I have a bone on my sword. You can't tell me that...
We don't have time for unlimited blade merch. We got freaking Kingdom Hearts!
Okay, fair enough. Well, we're past fame. We're moving on to Kingdom Hearts. Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I will see your holy grail and raise you the heart of everything. it's oh boy.
The great battle with Xehanort is almost upon us. As you know, you must take action to keep the Seven Pure Knights safe. Thus, we must hasten to assemble the Seven Guardians of Light.
It is finally going to get an official roster.
To return to our world, the three Keyblade wielders we lost over a decade.
Finally!
Ventus, Terra, and Aqua must be saved from their sad end, for they have more to
achieve. Axel got a Keyblade, didn't he?
Battle with Xehanort, Ventus's heart refused to awaken, and so Aqua found a safe location to receive him.
And that location was Castle Oblivion.
When she set off in search of her other missing friend, Terra, she fell to a place from which there is no return without outside help.
Kinda wish I brought my organization code with me.
I saw her in the realm of darkness.
Is that voice different?
It's been different for a while, actually. The dude who played Mickey died after one of the, Kingdom Hearts game. I wanted to say it was 358 of 2.
Oh, sad. But I want to say the voice in 358 and Birth by Sleep are the same, weren't they? Well, they came out about the same time, though, didn't they?
I'm not for sure.
I want to say they came out like right alongside each other, but it's been a long time. I don't remember all the dates.
I'm not going to pretend to know release dates. I know lore.
Yeah.
I will lure the heck out of you, but past.
We're dating this again. There we go.
Sorry. Don't need that copyright strike. Not this early.
Yeah, no. Not even off the ground yet. That and the time on the recording for the capture card is already approaching 10 minutes. And we haven't even gotten to the game yet.
Looking at you, Pepsi. Dr. Pepper, Pepsi. Okay.
I'm the one who's got Pepsi tonight.
Oh boy.
We're not even sponsored while we have product placement or sellouts.
Oh boy.
The Enchanted Castaway from Cinderella? Or is that something else?
It might be a sleeping world.
Dark world?
Dark
world. Oh, I think I know what happened.
I'm not playing.
Okay, well, I think. No. Actually, you know what? That's Disney Castle for all the Disney logos. Isn't it?
Yeah, you know, we may skip over the tutorial, but I don't want to be a total scrub.
Yeah, okay.
Hey,
Steel Rock and Ericus's Keyblade. Castle of Dreams. Yeah, that's from Cinderella's world. Okay. You're in the dark world, but the Castle of Dreams is there. I'm gonna guess this is what happened when the world got taken over by the darkness. Like, you know, end of the world in the first game is like the fragments of what's left. And this must be like the mirror side of that, I think. If I'm to try to draw any conclusions without seeing the entire thing first. Cinderella's world was destroyed, wasn't it?
An interesting note we might put into the actual tutorial, you can actually combo without hitting anything with this one, which is not a common thing throughout the games.
Okay, how do you... Aqua has got to be, like, super extremely overpowered because she's already leveled up all on her own, and that's really Eric's keyblade. So, she's got to be pretty freaking strong, right? Say it controls more like the other console, Kingdom Hearts?
It feels more like Kingdom Hearts.
You say it feels more like the original?
Yeah, it feels like more like Kingdom Hearts 2, but there's not a command slot system, so...
In the realm of light, do days or years pass with each step? I know something has started to go wrong.
Well, that's why you haven't aged a day.
I must hurry.
Look, call me a fanboy, but I'm okay with that.
I don't see there's anything wrong with it.
I was the weird person who played Aqua as the main character on Burnout Sleep. So.
Question I have about keyblades, how can she wield Eryx's keyblade?
Because a keyblade wielder can give their keyblade to someone else, a la King Mickey giving Star Sacred Sword so he can go into Valor form.
But the question I have though is, Eryx has died and didn't... Oh wait, never mind, you're right, I remember that.
Keyblades can be passed down because Xehanort's keyblade's actually one that's been passed down to him.
Yeah, I remember Eryx gave command to Aqua in case things... I remember him basically saying, if things go to crap, take my keyblade and hide our pipe sanctuary or something like that. So basically, even if Eric is still alive,
yeah.
And then she used her keyblade and her armor to get Terra out of the darkness and back to the other side, right?
Yep.
Okay. So we're
on the same page.
Yeah, so we're all on the same page, right? Give or take.
Oh.
That's okay.
Brutal.
Okay, I like the finisher here because it looks a lot. I think Kingdom Hearts 2 was the one who first started with the whole finisher. Little screen that did that after a sequenced fight that wasn't a boss battle. But this one's a lot more smooth, and I like the multiple angles instead of just the one and the...
Okay, we might cut this part out, but I thought I was saying I could go ahead and customize my, thing.
No, not yet.
Oh boy, there is outfit changing.
Oh!
I need it.
Oh, we got a trophy. Wandering in the dark.
I need it.
Okay, SpongeBob.
At least I wasn't changing I'm ready as we loaded in.
Okay, this world is...
I took it for granted.
Is that Traverse Town?
I thought I had
no! Notre Dame? Is that freaking Notre Dame?
Maybe.
Again, I haven't played Dream Drop, so I don't remember exactly, but that looks a lot like Notre Dame.
This is why you need to be caught up. I couldn't tell because I couldn't get a good look at the area, but...
It looks like... An old rustic town that looks like it was probably built sometime in the 1400s. The only world that comes to mind with that would be Cinderella's world and, well, Notre Dame. But Cinderella's world, you just go in the castle, you don't go to the town. The flashbacks. Flashbacks for days. Ah, Stitch!
Dude, I've got so many feels here.
See, I'm better watching it in HD instead of on a little PSP screen.
You too. Everyone in this world thought that they were safe. Not just the people, but the dog waiting for his.
crack at it?
Yeah.
Grief in this place is too much to fathom.
Yeah, there may actually be a radiant garden now that I think about it.
Might be.
Because
I mean, it looks kind of like the place where you meet Merlin the first time in Birth by Sleep.
Yeah, and Radiant Garden did fall into darkness and then became Hollow Bastion, so.
You can't keep on wishing for the past.
Oh boy.
Objectives. Oh, that's new. Follow the objective. Reward with clothing and accessories for Aqua's wardrobe.
Defeat the chef.
Figaro. Is that what this is?
Faraga.
Sorry, I'm kind of nearsighted when it comes to reading. I can't see what that says. Ooh! That's why I thought it said Figaro, because Figaro is the name of Minnie's cat. So, Aqua's your new wife, though?
No.
Which is already
reserved for someone else. We won't get into that right now. Let's go.
It's Trombon.
No, it's not.
It's not?
No, I'm afraid you would kill me over that. I
miss that. I miss whacking random objects to get mana and HP loads out. It's been far too long since I've worked in the universe. I'm just gonna whack everything I see.
We have a time frame here.
Okay, let's go. How do you dodge roll?
You just tap square while holding a direction. Okay. It's the same as the old dodge rolls. It just didn't dawn on me at first.
It's been a minute.
It doesn't help
okay.
The dodge rolls not again. Never again.
What if the first boss is guard armor again? Like in like four other Kingdom Hearts games.
Yeah, she must get really tired of the ground.
I mean, this is only, what, the fifth time?
The world collapsed when the clock advanced.
Oh. Getting an Ultimisha vibe from this.
There is no time in this place, only the clock.
Makes
sense. Oh, Lord, this is going to be time manipulation. Of maintenance.
something broke, hit it until it works. Reverse the winds and sun. Turn back tide and time. Alright, that's part one. Now where's the rest? Now the objective must be find the rest of the clock cogs. Oh, now we have magic.
Okay, yeah, this is a lot like Kingdom Hearts 2.
Shortcuts.
If I find enough gears, I can restore
the world. Alright, so gotta go back then.
See, I'm just waiting for slow motion to suddenly hit me again.
Yes. Oh, that was beautiful. Oh, it froze into the ground.
Spell interaction.
All right. My personal favorite. R1? It's not working.
It was
already locked on. Oh, okay. Oh, lock on. Okay. Which button is it?
Circle is thunder.
Okay, yes. You're... No, circle is fire. It is because your TV isn't wide enough for this. Your TV isn't wide enough for this.
I just have weird settings.
Alright.
So what's your thing? First impressions?
It's been far, far too long. Not just from waiting on this game, but since I've actually played a Kingdom Hearts on a console. Like, oh, there we go.
I hate to admit it, but I kind of finished fighting the organization members in 2.5 in like 4 days ago.
Yeah, no shame in that.
I took a little
wait. Level 51 already?
Nope.
Well, okay, fair enough, because this is supposed to be a pickup where we left off in Birth by Sleep, so.
So I guess critical level is not a thing in this
one. You get a Thundaga! You get a Thundaga! You all get a Thundaga! okay, that's freaking awesome.
I think that's what froze it.
Either that or it's frozen because the clock stopped moving. Aqua said there's gear on the bridge, right?
I missed it if she did.
I want to glide. Given how broken...
It feels like an open-world exploration.
Yeah, I'm actually half expecting to, like, fall to my death, but that's never been a thing in Kingdom Hearts. This is... I can't go any further?
Okay.
Can't go up there? No. Oh. Was I just running on empty air?
No, you're running.
I'm,
like,
I'm jumping, okay.
See that shining spot way over there?
That right there? Between the... Yeah.
To your left.
To my left?
Yeah, that shining spot.
That little...
The big, bright...
I see,
right
I see.
There in the middle.
Oh, treasure chest. Go there. The one thing I liked about 2 over 1 was that you could actually open chests outside of battle. Or, inside battle, I mean. In 1, you had to be outside of battle. So, this is what happens when Kingdom Hearts meets the distortion world for Pokemon Platinum. Because that's what this feels like. Chaos, darkness, and everything floating in space.
Pokemon crossover.
Meh.
Yeah, for some reason I don't feel that too much.
Yeah, I can't blame you too much, because Pokemon's crossover just about everything. Well, at least in terms of, you know, fan art and all that.
Let's not get into that.
We're not. I'm just kidding.
Get into fan art and stuff gets weird.
Hey, yes, my friend. I've been on the air for quite a while.
Remember,
yeah.
Not sure it does something, but I'm like sure it does. Oh, yep, Cura Stick just blows your HP bar and MP bar.
Okay. Well, duly noted.
Well, I just switch out all the cars.
Yeah. Okay. Alright, actually, here in a couple minutes, I think after we find the next one. No, we can find all the cards for you in this episode. It shouldn't be too far away. Still got 3 more to find.
Let's see.
Double. Unlock a new skill.
Now see, my big question is what stops the clock from just saying, lol, I'm gonna go forward again while you're trying to collect me?
Yeah, because it moved forward on its own second ago, unless someone is playing jokes on us and just having to hit all the cogs at once. Maybe the 13 seconds of darkness were hiding, like, yeah, I'm gonna hit this gear and pray for progressing just to be a little bit. Chain of Memories. I'm not talking about Re-Chain of Memories, I mean the Game Boy Advance one. Because, you know, that one got a whole lot of backlash because of the card-based system, but I loved it just because I love Game Boy Advance, I love the sprites, I love all that kind of stuff, and it was really, I guess, what's the word for it? It's not really innovative or revolutionary, but to be able to carry Kingdom Hearts with you and still have the same spirit as the original game, like, not necessarily in terms of gameplay, but in terms of characters and story, even having the voiceovers and some cinematics that were almost on par with PS1 on the Game Boy Advance. That was something really cool at the time. It's a bit more of a novelty now, but it's still my favorite one. Oh yeah, and the best part, you play as Riku. Free play the entire game.
Battle and then just trying to back off. Right, with all of these, I feel like all of these are on my control.
Yeah. That was beautiful.
It's sort of like the command styles from Earth possibly.
Ah, I get it. Except without the ungodly loading time.
Yeah, I believe it's based off of the damage unit.
Yeah. Makes sense. Okay. That's all of them?
Okay. Oh.
Alright, now.
Yeah, you just kind of press trying.
Yep. Which way did you come from? This way?
Yeah.
So we need to go back, or I need to go down further?
Go up.
Did you ever go this way yet?
I don't think there's anything else that way.
Yeah, you're right. It's just a platform.
My favorite has got to be Kingdom Hearts 2, honestly, because just the amount of minor mechanics that you can learn in that game was staggering.
I like Kingdom Hearts 2. I really like the villain, but there's one thing I have to give 1 over 2. The Sephiroth battle.
I can agree there. The first time I did that with the Invisible HP armor. Boy.
You had no clue what you were doing, and it was just a total mind break. You're just like, I'm not even doing any damage to this guy. I'm scared out of my wits. What's going on here? Well, at least
you can go that way.
Just go down. That's gravity. At least that was my first impression when I first encountered him.
Yeah, and
in Kingdom Hearts 2, you could see his HP meter the entire time, and just being able to block.
He just felt a little bit more difficult in Kingdom Hearts
1. Yeah, that's the key word, feel. But I think that, on the whole, he actually was harder in 2, but it's just really the shock factor in the first game that really throws you off guard.
The only thing I would give him that made him harder in 2...
When he used Heartless Angel, he floated above the ground. Unless he had high jump leveled all the way up, you couldn't reach him.
Or you could instantly use Limit Break to teleport to him.
Shh. Don't make me feel bad. Don't make me feel bad about that. No, seriously, I
just remember, friend, that I used to be very, very adept.
Okay.
Well, it's getting about 30 minutes, so I think we should probably start
there. Now, let's find the last cog first.
There's two more cogs.
No, just one. That's a 5.
Oh.
So, well, it's gotta be nearby. Where are you going? This way? Okay, I know we've been up. Oh, wait. Oh, that's it up there. Yeah, let's go. I was about to say, I'm pretty certain we've been up this way. Oh, that's where I went earlier. Isn't it?
Yeah, I need it.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's. This is where I went to earlier, trying to climb up out of the map.
Yeah.
And now the cog is there. Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's where I was jumping around this light pole. So yeah, there we go. Out of the way. Trophy here, Dark Explorer. Okay, yeah, I see a little arrow meter down there. It's kind of like a little max super punch. Gotta build it up and then unleash the power of the sun!
Or in this case, when it's well placed, you would just have to do it instantly.
Yeah.
That was cool. Like, that was just cool.
There we go. Okay. Shot. Hold R1 to lock on to targets, and then press X to fire.
Oh, yes.
I have a feeling this is going to be very, very fun.
It's so pretty.
I didn't do much. Only got a few hits on him, though.
He also didn't get high rings.
That's true. Just random auto jump? Okay.
He's sliding down.
Okay. Oh, yeah, because it's gravity, right? Okay, now I see you've got the limited gauge filled up down there or whatever. No, because my MP's in me. Fire! So is that like a Ragnarok kind of, or is that a... Ragnarok is the one where Sora does that big epic combo with the Keyblade, and then he shoots off his gigantic blast of laser beams.
I was going to trying to think of the Shotlock. It's a Shotlock from Breath of the
Oh, okay.
But I always use the Rapid Snap ones.
Right. The one I always used was the one where, like, where Ventus and Terra would spin around in place and just shoot bullets everywhere. Keeps you invincible and deals out constant damage. But I think
you're going the wrong way.
Yeah. I beat Ventus' story mode when I was way underleveled, and I beat Vanitas by basically just shot-locking him into submission. Cheap strategy.
It's that way to the left.
Okay, yeah. Cheap strategy, but I was impatient to finish the game, so... I'll just move past this one and see what comes next. Okay, yeah. Boss battle! Oh, is it gonna be a dark side? No? Oh, nope. There we go. Holy crap! Well, that was a lot of lasers. Just a big, massive swarm of shadow markers.
This is like that thing from the first trailer.
I'm almost dead, and my MP is exact back up yet.
You gotta get defensive.
Better defensive than offensive. Nope. Okay, okay.
I didn't even register as a
pun. And that is what I feel. Okay, do we have a block command this time?
Yeah.
I swear. Like always?
That's right, you tried.
Crap.
Now you're in
the game. And now I'm dead.
Well,
you just want to
force wall break in here? My controller's dying.
Yep, okay, so I think on that note, we should end this episode then. Cut back for the next one with the boss battle.
Sounds good to me.
Well, you just saw me royally screw things up. Well, this has been Blake Cross EXT and Ryoji 42, part of Flashing Blade Productions, and this has been our first look at Kingdom Hearts 0.2?
2.8.
No, I mean, the name of this particular segment is 0.2.
Oh. Well, yeah.
Kingdom Hearts 2.8, the segment 0.2. Alright, well, we're gonna keep this going all that long, so, you know, tune into the next video. Peace out.
See you in a minute. Peace.